You have to wait, sir.
Okay. All right, I'll wait. Let me know when to start.
हेलो हेलो
हेलो यस
सर, वी आर स्टार्टिंग आवर सेशन.
ओके
ओके नाउ जय मैडम, यू हैव टू गिव इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ सागर सर.
A very good morning to all of you present here, and thank you for joining us. Hitkarni Prashikshan Mahila Mahavidyalay is very happy to conduct this 3 days webinar on new trends for effective teaching learning in present scenario. Yesterday we have two effective presentations. In the first session we had Professor Dr. Ashok Kumar Gupta, Vice President, Research Foundation of India, presently at Boston, USA. He has given lecture on new trends for effective teaching learning in present scenario. In the second session, we had Mr. Abel T. Sunil, CEO at Atos Innovations. He has given lecture on importance of technology in education. It is my pleasure to invite great academician, young researchers from all over the world to this webinar. I, Jaya Samdekar, Assistant Professor, Hitkarni Prashikshan Mahila Mahavidyalay, am particularly happy to be present in this unique event to exchange the views with such delegates. Today, we are having two sessions. We will start first with the Mr. Umesh Sagar sir. Sir is technology enthusiast and entrepreneur from California. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Ms. Jaya. Thank you for the great introduction. So yes, to begin sir, with,
Umesh Sagar sir is native of Agra with the master's degree in technology from IIITM Gwalior. He headed to California, USA in 2008. Umesh Sagar sir is a technology enthusiast and an entrepreneur. He has pioneered in the field of technology by contributing his expertise with many giants like CIS, Cisco, MarketShare, Pizza Hut, and so on. He also owns a technology startup in Mumbai. Mr. Umesh Sagar is an established restaurateur. He owns multiple vegetarian restaurants in the San Francisco Bay, California. His ideology is making the world a better place. And what can be better way than giving it back? Little that we know, an active volunteer in his community. He has devoted himself in serving various non-profit organizations as an executive member on the panel. He supports and facilitates many American public schools, educators with assistive technology, and provides guidance. So today, sir will provide us lecture on engaging the classroom. Please welcome, sir. Now you can continue, sir.
Thank you, Ms. Jaya, for the wonderful introduction. Really appreciate that. And since you have already introduced me so well, so I will skip my introduction part from my side and I will move to the next slide. So let's get to the business. So as we already know that what we are going through, this COVID has created such a situation for each and everyone that we are not able to deal with the deal in a regular way in any form. So our world has changed due to this current pandemic situation. And during these times, we will also need to evolve. We have technological advancement in our favor. So thanks to Digital India, we have access to high-speed internet, smartphones, and variety of online services. What do we need to do in order to stay connected with students mainly? That is the, I feel that education is the backbone of any infrastructure. So lacking in education is the worst thing a country or a nation can do. So how do we make sure that we fill this gap and we make sure that we do not lag at all when it comes to the need of the community? And that is the most important need. So in order to fulfill this gap in this time period, what can we do to make sure that we continue to provide the quality service we are trying to provide to our youth who are the future of this nation? So in this sense, I would say we already have some of the tools available. We might not be aware how to use them. So my presentation in that sense will take you step by step. How can we make sure that we use those tools which are available to us and make them available to all other people, provide them guidance and teach them to be online. So on this point, I would like to say, first thing, student engagement, it has become a challenge, very big challenge these days, because schools are closed and students are sitting at home. Teachers are also trying to do something from their end, but there is no common platform in order to provide this quality service. We, at this present time, have technologies available which can help us eliminate this gap. So using technology for distance learning, I believe is the future. Even if this pandemic go away, online teaching has been readily available in the past, and this time we just have to use it at its full extent. So what do we need to do in order to go deeper into distance learning? I'll start with, let's say, teacher and students both need to be creative. Different people have different accessibility and preferences for technology. Teachers and students also need to understand and empathize each other's situation, as there might be restrictions from both sides. Those restrictions can be anything, especially during these challenging times. Someone has some kind of environment, somebody else has some kind of environment, someone has some kind of need, or someone does not have that kind of need. So for example, I'll give you, teachers might not have childcare for their children, or student may be facing some family crisis due to this COVID situation. That is the reason teacher need to be creative. I would say use variety of medium and tool for students to access their curriculum in flexible form. We have to make sure that we keep our students engaged in any way possible. And there are few steps we can, few measures we can take in order to achieve those goals. So the first point in here, make a hub. Make a hub means a predictable place where students and families who have tech can go and can publish their plan. Teachers can use, let's say, Google Classroom with the Google Classroom or other mode of communication, Outlook, and suggest assignment setup weekly. Then another form is websites. So let's say Hitkarni also have a website available. So dedicating a page for all the updated information and keeping all the resources available readily for all the students will surely help in this kind of scenario. Then another resource gathering we can do is, let's say, on when we are providing these resources through a web page, we can either provide printable versions, which students can print at their home, but the challenge is that we are not sure if the students have a printer or not. In order to handle this challenge, we can surely provide photocopies to students. And this happened particularly in my case also, where my daughter goes to school. And when this all started, in order to deal with this situation, they just provided a bunch of information packages to us, where students can go home and do their homework, what they would usually do. And after that, they all started conducting meetings on a regular basis. So what are the best practices for educating online? I've pointed out 3 points, which I feel are really, really crucial in order to start your online education curriculum. First thing, it is important to understand that live online learning is not a plug and play solution. It takes planning and preparation. You should use the system that you are familiar with to get up and running for temporary or extended closure. So if I explain them in detail, planning and preparation is the key to successful and engaged class. Just like regular classroom teaching, lesson plans, instructions, goals, and expectations should be clearly formulated before initiating online learning. We need to make sure that students are able to understand thoroughly, clearly, what we are trying to tell them. For example, keeping track of curriculum, giving assignments with precise instructions, assignment deadlines, and assignment gradings. If the student is failing, we need to know what reasons they are failing. So if they are failing to respond, say, let's say for online teaching, it is very important for an educator or the institute to personally get connected with the family or student to understand the failure of accessing online learning. Now, institute also plays a very crucial role in this. Institute also need to understand that they should make sure and support teachers and students' technological needs. Not necessarily everyone has all the resources available to them. So we need to look into each and individual case, what they are in need of, and we need to act accordingly. Now for the next sheet, I would say, what do we need to do to prepare our session from home? So there are a couple of things which are must to have in order to do anything online: technology, software, environment, apparel, and recommendations. So when it comes to technology, we need to make sure that we are ready with technology stack, such as laptop, proper lighting, proper internet connection. And we also need to make sure that the laptop what we are using is fully charged. And in case if we do not have laptop, we are trying to take it on phone, that is fine too. But in case of desktop it becomes very challenging in India when the light goes off. So we have to make sure that we have some kind of backup available to make our computer running and the internet connection going on. Now, when it comes to software, I know that being in education field, you guys are expertise. You guys have expertise in each one of your topics, but not necessarily you have to have an expertise in software as well. So you might have your own challenges where you are new to the system, where you do not understand that system. I would say in these kind of scenarios, it's completely fine to reach out to your administrators, to reach out to your technical staff and ask them to help you out. They can do either Zoom meetings with you, or they can do TeamViewer where they can access your system remotely and they can help you with the setup of whatever technical needs you have. Now, environment, apparel and recommendations. So everybody is from different background. We all come from different kind of families. We all have different kind of situation. First of all, we need to be respectful to those situations. And we need to show support to make sure that we are not discouraging, but encouraging students to participate in this. But there are certain responsibilities on our side too, where we have to, in order to involve them in this new kind of sessions, new kind of technology, we need to provide them, this information in a way where they should not feel disconnected. So there are a few things I think we should take care in these kind of scenarios where we will need to create a distraction-free learning environment for them. We will also need to make sure that when we are coming into any online session, we are properly dressed up and we have to keep our surrounding at a place where there's not too much distraction happening. Now, this does not mean that all of these things can met all together. There are challenges. And when you are with the family, you can't find secluded place. Some sort of distraction should be understandable. And over here in America, in fact, companies have said this very, very clearly that even if you are there in the online session, your kids walk to you, your other kind of activities, we need to appreciate and even if not encourage those, but should not feel bad about those things. It's, we all are human beings. We all are here for the same purpose. I'll go to the next. So what do we need to do to conduct session from home? There are a few very important points in here. The most important point is communication. Communication with your student while working with them for a distance learning is very, very critical. Don't underestimate the need of over-communicate on the phone or in an email. Keep these best practices in mind. As a teacher, what do we need to do? And what our students need to do? So when we go to what we need to do, there are certain important points I feel are very crucial in order to communicate proactively and providing quality guidelines to all the students involved in the curriculum. First point in this is, let's say if you are going to hold a group session, make sure you have provided prior written notice. So prior written notice, it is very important for us, our educators, to keep track of students being informed. And as an educator, we need to make sure that we log those students in attendance. Now, second one, create a schedule that both you and the students can see. So in this kind of scenario, we already have multiple tools available at our disposal, such as Outlook, Google Reminders, and Google email. You can set up Google emails. You can communicate through Google emails as well. Now, next one, prepare your material ahead of time and avoid spending time during the session. So in this, planning, organizing, and preparation are the key for the successful classroom sessions. We have to make sure that we go through each and everything what we are going to share with the students. And it's no different than how we actually do in our regular classes. When we go to classes, we have to do some kind of pre-prep. We have to make sure that we pre-prepare our notes. So instead of wasting time figuring out things during the session, we need to go pre-prepared with that. Now these few things are in addition to what we are used to of doing. So communicate by email, phone, or chat application. This is something which we usually do not do when we do our normal classes. But these days, it's not necessary that everyone has same set of technology or technological stack available. So somebody might have email address, might not. There are reasons people do miss their reading their email. Do not hesitate to contact them by phone number, or these days we have so many chat applications available. So for example, WhatsApp, we can create a group which will let you create a group of around 250 people, and you can communicate through that channel as well to your class. Now, send reminders prior to a live online session. What that means is that we know that, let's say we have scheduled a meeting through Outlook or any other channel. We have to make sure that students are reaching or attending those sessions on time. But not necessarily everyone will keep track of those reminders. So we can set up those email reminders, and when those email reminders will trigger, let's say half an hour in advance, student will also get prep time to join if they are busy with some other things. Practice shared material ahead of time before live session. This is another very important point where we have to get used to of sharing these live materials in advance, where students at least can get a preview of those materials. They can maybe prepare some of their questions. They can ask their doubts. And that way, they are not hesitant to attend your live sessions. Now, live sessions should be engaging and informative. That is the very most crucial point in here, that we have to make sure that these sessions, how do we make sure, first of all, that these sessions are engaging? So when we get the habit of sharing these materials in advance, students get to review them, they feel more confident. And when they are confident, you get their best attention. So make sure that you are providing them these information a bit ahead of the time, and you can get the best attention from your students. Now, option for students to ask questions and clarify doubt. This is something which we should get a habit of putting it in the very front, in the very beginning of our session, where we, before starting any session, we tell students that, okay, if you have a doubt or any question or any concerns, you can surely ping or raise your hand via these online portals, or you can write down your question, and at the very end, we can explain them in detail. So that way, students are not losing track of what they are doing. So this last thing was what, as an educator, you are supposed to do. But then you also need to make sure that there are certain responsibilities which falls on students. And they also need to fulfill their responsibilities. So in that sense, there are certain expectations from students, what they should be doing, and what kind of support we can provide to make those things happen. So few things over here, such as, let's say a student should have a working computer, high-speed internet connection, webcam, headset. These days, most of the laptops have the webcam pre-installed, so we might not need that. Headset, again, it's an optional, but having a working computer and high-speed internet connection is must. Now, if they do not have it, then we have to make sure that they choose an alternative to be present when these live sessions are happening. They should also have calendar invite with information on the topic. So this is again on when as an educator, we are prepared, we are pre-providing them information and making sure that they have gone through some kind of basic understanding of what we are trying to teach them. And by providing that topic in the calendar, if we are making sure that they are mentally prepared to attend the online lecture with their full attention. Now, the third point in this, to join live online session, at a time of our scheduled session, please make sure that you have a quiet place. So it's not easy to emphasize more on this, but we still need to make sure that students also do understand the need of this crisis, and education is important for them. So they have to find some kind of place for themselves where they are not getting distracted by other household activities. They are not getting bothered by other family members. If they have certain restrictions, they can request their family members to be not available or to go and go somewhere else, or maybe they take some kind of corner in their house where they feel they can be left out for some period of time. Now, next one, open Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox internet browser and provide clickable links. So it's not just about providing them what kind of resources they have, but they should be, all those resources should be easily accessible to them. So whenever we are preparing something, we have to make sure that if we are providing some information about the topic, that topic might not be available throughout or with full information in that lecture itself. So we have to provide them resources for that information. And we can provide links in form of, in this presentation, right? We can provide them certain links where they can click through and read in more detail. Now, provide them instructions that they may be prompted to allow access to your microphone and camera for Zoom virtual classes. What that means is that every online portal have their own way of behaving. So if we are, let's say, using Zoom, we have to tell them a bit in advance that they need to go through certain steps to get themselves ready to attend these sessions. So providing them pre-instructions will surely help them to go through this. Now, what are the instructional strategies for live online learning? again, we discuss these things, but we can go through them. Engage your student with personality, passion, and enthusiasm. Student should always feel that when we are calling them for online session, we are as excited as anybody could be. We have to make sure that they understand that whatever we are trying to teach them, it is very important. And it is for them and their own good. Set clear expectations. We have to make sure that they understand the need of the current times. And it's not just this, that they, if the student are thinking that, oh, it's a temporary thing. No. In most of the countries outside India, even in India these days, online learning has become a big game changer. Now we are forced to go on maximum online learning. So we need to make sure that we make them understand that this can be the future for a very long time. Create a supportive learning environment. We have to make sure that not everybody's situation is same, and everyone can have their own challenges, just not students, but teachers as well. We teachers have their family members too, and they have to take care of their kids and other people in the family. Students have their family members, but we need to create a supporting environment where they do understand the need of learning in current scenario. Now, use a mix of learning tools that are readily available for better engagement. That means that there are multiple tools. It's not one tool or two tools. There are tons of tools available in the market. Now, that doesn't mean that we need to go through all of those and get bits and pieces. We can use some of the tools for very specific purposes, but we should also make sure that we get some kind of mastery in some kind of tools. Now, what do we need to do as an educator in order to plan outside of the classroom? For communication purpose, we have Remind, WhatsApp, or Telegram. Telegram is the new app which is getting very famous, because WhatsApp has a limitation of how many users you can have, where Telegram does not. Remind is an app where you can send reminders to your students for anything needed related to the curriculum. Then second point, get organized. Moderate the discussion to keep it positive and constructive. So this word organize and moderate is very crucial in this. It's very, very important. Being a teacher, we have the responsibility of being organized, but we also need to keep control of what is going in that session. And we have to deal with all the kids with the positive attitude, where they take it constructively. Create a schedule and stick to it. I know it's not easy these days being at home and be on a schedule, but if you have created a schedule, make sure that you have a supportive environment and request everyone to stick to that schedule. Plan your morning and afternoon routines. With this, everybody get used to of the normal day's schedule, but when it comes to providing quality education, we have to create a proper schedule. We have to plan our whole morning, our afternoon. We have to go through those routines and follow those routines. Fifth, don't forget to plan emails, phone calls, outreach, live session, and students. Recorded videos, video chat, and video chat with administrator and staff. So this is not just about doing all these things for your students only. You need to be involved with your colleagues as well. So whatever medium you prefer, if you prefer to communicate to your colleagues via emails, well and good. If you prefer to talk to them on phone, just reach out to them. You have to make sure to keep it as much as inclusive. Now, follow up, 6 point, follow up, meet up with colleagues, tea, coffee breaks, walks, and lunch. So some of these points are very, very interesting where we do not have regular schedule, but at being at home, that doesn't mean that we cannot eat lunch with each other or we cannot decide to drink coffee with each other. We can definitely do those that will help lighten up the environment, lighten up the mood, and it will help you also lighten up the whole situation. Now, last one in this, your self-care is critical, and minimizing stress in your day by creating a structure. So when you have created something with the proper plan, you are trying to execute it, make sure that you do enough revisions beforehand where at the last moment you are not struggling. Having that structure in your life will take a lot of stress out of your hand. If you're planning to do last minute lectures or preparations, that will definitely put too much pressure when you're going to attend your online session. These are some of these examples, learning tools. We already using Zoom. Zoom is very famous. Everybody is using. And then there's Google Meet. Google has actually the full stack of all the technological needs we have. Google Classroom. In fact, my daughter is attending all her class through Google Classroom. So I found it very, very important in this scenario. I've written over here some of the resources. Maybe I can click on one of these and give you a quick brief on what you can get out of those. Down the line, when I send this PPT to you guys, finalize one, you can check all these resources and you can choose either of those. But when I did my research, I found some of these were the best and very, very easy to learn. So this page has been created by Google, where you will see Teach from Home. They have most of all the necessary information available on this page. Over here, what kind of tools you might need and how to use those tools. This is for teachers specifically. If you want to go through schools, this is for schools. If you want to use this in your personal life, you can do that too. That is for families. How can I learn about the technology my child is using for a school that is part of family, right? For teachers, how do I teach remotely with video calls? So over here, if you click on all these resources available, you will get a tutorial on each and individual technology in very detail with easy steps they have mentioned, how you can create all the technology profile for yourself and get the best out of it. How do I manage a virtual classroom? Create your first assignment, make a class website for your student, structure your lessons with Google Slide, create, share, and edit Google Docs. Google has a full stack of technology for saving your resources. Let's say you have Excel sheet and you have a Word document, you are provided certain amount of space in Google, which is around 15 GB, good enough for handling all these things. You can store all those things in a drive. You can create folders, just like how you would do things normally on your laptop. There are a few other resources available here. How do I keep my students engaged? where what you need to do, what kind of support system you need to create for your students, what you need to do when you need to create one-on-one instructional lecture with your students. If you want to get a quiz, you can do that too. Provide real-time Google feedback in Docs. You can ask your students or their family members to provide feedback on online form. How do I keep in touch with the other teachers? Another great resource over here with all detailed information available. You just need to go and click on this. And then connect with your local community. So making sure that what is happening in your surrounding, just go through those. So this way, with this, you can surely make sure that you are getting enough material and knowledge to engage yourself with the students. Some of the other resources are here, Google Classroom. I have shown you that video. If you click on this, you will get step-by-step instructions on how to create a Google Classroom where you can assign your quiz or your test to the students. You can put daily reading material on those. Zoom is again good for online meetings. Web WhatsApp, not necessarily you need to connect through your phone for WhatsApp. You can just click on this link and you will get a QR code to scan, and then your phone will be connected to your laptop. Then Khan Academy is another good resource for all the online education resources. Starfall is very great resource for getting information for kids curriculum. So with this, I will conclude my lecture. Any questions from you guys?
Hello.
If no questions, I would like to conclude this. Hello?
Sir, please, you have to wait.
Yes.
Question answer sessions will be started.
Okay. Okay. All right. Sounds good.
If you have any query, you will ask question. Hello.
Yes.
Hello. If you have any query, you clear it from your question in chat box.
So I see some questions over here. Which type of tools we used? Please give some example and in which website we get this tool asked. All right. So I've already given the tool in the resource page, and you can click on those resource pages. And you can click on those resource pages to go to those available online tools. The second question is there any provision to record this video or watch it later? So maybe Jaya ma'am can clarify on that, or Tipti ma'am or Sulakshana ma'am, anyone?
Yes. I'm checking, sir, just so now.
Yes, so it is recorded and it will be available for later purposes. Any other question?
Sir, I want to know about the Zoom. Some people say Zoom is not perfect app for teacher. What about it?
So, there was some kind of technical glitch initially where the security lapse was there in Zoom. But in order to deal with it, they have come up with a new model where they are actually not just providing you user ID or Zoom ID, but now they provide you option option for users to join Zoom meetings by using password as well. So let's say if you have invited multiple people into this session, issue used to be where they were not able, that anyone with that link could just come in, and if hacker is able to create that random generator number, they can also come and peek into your sessions. But Zoom is taking care of that by providing additional option to input password.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, someone asked one question. How to Google Classroom to create online class?
So, Google Classroom to create online class, maybe I can do a real quick display on my previous sheet. Give me a second and I can give you a brief on that. So in this link, you see classroom.google.com. Once you go on this, I also tried to create one class for you guys as a test class, and you can go step by step instructions on how to create that class. Now, in order to get more detailed information on what to do in order to create a class, in this PDF, there is a way to create your first class assignment in Google Classroom. So the first link which I've shared on my resource, that will give you overall detailed overall information on all the tools Google have for you to be successful as online educator. In order to go in any of the detailed information, you can go to certain sections of this and you can follow the steps they have mentioned. They have a tutorial for each and everything. So for creating classroom, get started with Google Classroom. First of all, you need to make sure that you have Google account. But once you have Google account, you can go through this simple video and you can learn classroom creation in few steps only. Next question, please.
Now, next question is, how can we interact with those students who did not have any tools of online classes?
Sorry, you got cut off. So what is the question again?
How can we interact with those students who don't have any tools of online classes?
So that is the biggest challenge. And in order to deal with it, I included that information in one of my sheets, that definitely it's a true scenario where it's not possible for everyone to have online tools available. And best methodology for that is, I believe, that we create or pre-print whatever resources we are supposed to give to the students. So let's say if they need certain reading assignments, we print those, make a Xerox copy in the office, we bundle them. And if they need certain questionnaires, we print those in the institute, and then we can leave them outside the class and communicate with the students that they have certain type or certain kind of printable version of resources needed for them to do at home, available at the doorsteps of the class. So students can come or parents can come, not necessarily they need to come or at the same time, but you can definitely provide them a specific day that it will be available. You can surely extend that day to multiple days based on how many people have taken. Someone might have got busy on that specific day, so they might not get time. They can come next day. So printable resources in this situation works the best.
Thank you, sir. Next question is from audience side. Can we take online video classes like Zoom on Google Classroom?
Yes. Google has an option to create your own videos. So what you can do is you can record your video and share later on with your students. So you can record your video, upload it to YouTube, then integrate that YouTube video into whatever classroom setup you have created on Google Classroom. And Google doesn't charge for all those things, right? The only thing what teachers need to make sure that they have recorded these kind of videos in a kind of environment where they do not get too much distraction. But yes, these tools are already available very easy to handle. And you can integrate those in Google Classroom with the utmost necessity. Also, there's one more thing. Yeah, there can be a situation where, let's say, a teacher is trying to take a class, but she doesn't have a scheduled time for that specific class. In this kind of scenario, teachers can surely record their video, re-upload, and run that video at the scheduled time. So it might not be a one-to-one interaction, but at least it will solve the purpose of providing what information need to reach out to the students.
Now, next question is, which is better, teach from home or Google Classroom?
Teaching from home has become our necessity, right, these days. It's not more than necessity, I would say. No, there are no other option for us. But teaching from home, we need to have tools in order to do that task or do that work. Google Classroom is a kind of tool which provide multiple technologies put together in order to provide all the resources at one place. So using all those tools, without tools, it's not easy to communicate or plan our lecture in a very efficient way. Google Classroom is just a tool where you use those tools to do these classes from home.
Sir, some children ask one question. Zoom classes too are not attentive. So is there any remedy for teaching 40 children at a time?
Yes. So if Zoom classes are not working out the way we want, there is a new tool which Google has launched called YouTube channel. And you can do live videos through those YouTube channels. Then again, if you go on Google Classroom and see the way they have structured all those classes, you can definitely make the best use of it. And they do not have restriction like such. Definitely in Zoom, yes, they do have certain restrictions based on what kind of plan they have. You have, but there's another thing to Zoom where you can, as a institute, educational institute, they do provide free resources or on low cost resources.
Sir,
which
one
usually
question.
Does not have.
Yes, continue, sir.
No, I'm done.
Can you please suggest what are the technologies we can use to create a better environment for online classes?
So technologies in the time, see, technology, it's not just one thing, right? Technology is very vast. Now you need to find what you need. And as an educator or as a student, what my needs are. First of all, we need to look at ourselves. Educators need to look at themselves, what their needs are. Students need to look at themselves, what their needs are. And then what kind of resources are available to them. And with those, when those resources are been put together, that is called the real technology. So we need to understand what our needs are. We need to find tools which fulfill those needs. And then we need to start collaborating with each other using those tools.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, you have explained each and everything very nicely. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
If you have any query, you will be sent in sir email ID. Sir will provide appropriate answer in your email ID.
So I will surely share my email ID. You guys have any kind of need, any
sir,
kind of
please question? Share your, please share your email ID.
I can actually put in this. I hope you guys can see my email ID over here. I just added up.
I can see.
It's sagarumesh@gmail.com. Any question you guys have, any concerns you guys have, any knowledge you guys need further in this aspect, feel free to reach out to me and I can definitely help you all out.
Thank you, sir. You have mentioned in your lecture best practice for educating online, prepare for your session from home, technologies, environment, software, recommendation, how we can engage classroom, and what do you need to do? You have mentioned in your lecture, go deeper into the distance learning. Give freedom to the student to ask questions. What you have a student need, engaging your student instructional strategies for live online learning planning outside of the classroom. You have given nicely examples in your lecture. You have mentioned a lot of resources about online learning classes, how you manage a virtual classes, how connect local community with learning, online learning classes. You have explained each and everything in your lecture very effective way. Sir, thank you so much. We are deeply grateful for the great effort you have put into the lecture. What a fantastic lecture you have gave. You really, you are an expert. Your remarkable depth of understanding the subject is appreciable. Your presentation was very effective, stimulating and informative. Once again, sir, thank you. Thank you so much for your lecture. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone, for giving me this golden opportunity to present myself in front of you all. I hope all the information I provided will help you guys. And if you have any further question, please again reach out to me on my email address and I will try to help you all as much as possible. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I'll disconnect now. You guys have a wonderful day ahead.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your precious lecture.
Thank you, Sulakshana, ma'am. Really appreciate your time and coordinating all this. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Hello. 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 Hello.
हेलो हेलो ये हमारा दूसरा सेशन अभी 10 मिनट के ब्रेक के बाद चालू होगा हाई टी के ब्रेक के बाद चालू होगा जैसे ही हमारा चालू होता है आप लोग वापस जुड़ जाइएगा ओके आपको दूसरी लिंक शेयर करेंगे इसके लिए ओके थैंक यू